Hey, I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, and I've got a cool Excel tip for you today.
Hey, this is Mike Joe Girvin at Excel is Fun on YouTube, and I have a different way to do that.
We have another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I want to send a shout-out to Joe with the Garvey Nut and Candy Company. Joe was talking to me about 6 months ago about a project we were going to do for Joe. And he says, hey, I love your videos at iTunes. I'm like, yeah, right, okay. And then he says, but you have to check out this guy. Excel is Fun. Hey, YouTube, he's even more enthusiastic than you are. And I'm like, what? And Joe says, and he has hundreds of videos. What? So now, for those of you following the netcast, of course, you know that Mike and I have met. We did a couple of podcasts together. Now this is our second dueling podcast. But if it hadn't been for Joe, who kind of got my competitive spirit up there. So this netcast is definitely showing some of my competitive nature. I said, Mike, we should show people how to create charts. We have a couple of data sets. Let's go through and see who has more Excel videos. And so, you know, as obviously if you're watching this podcast, you know about the Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast. This is episode number 885. But I also have other products. I have the live lessons for Excel 2007 and Excel 2003. There's 150 videos there. The total training DVD, the Advanced Excel 2007, another 60 videos there. The new High Def podcast, 40 videos there, and soon to come out, the Office Academy with 7 pivot table videos there for a total of 1152. And I knew that Mike had hundreds of videos at YouTube. It turns out 635. But Mike is a professor at Highline College in Seattle, and he's doing videos for his students. So for each one of his classes, there's more and more videos, and we added all of these up, and obviously, you can tell that I put it on the podcast. I'm winning slightly. Hooray for me. But the real point here is to take these two data sets and see how we can show them graphically. So I'm going to send this over to Mike. Mike's going to put together a chart, and then we'll come back, and I'll put together a chart. We'll see which one's better. Mike, take it away.
Hey, thanks, Mr. Excel. Hey, I have the same data set here, the video count for Mr. Excel, a video count for Excel is Fun. Now, if I'm going to compare these numbers to these, I want to rearrange them over here so they're next to each other. Not only that, but since I want to emphasize the difference, I'm going to use a horizontal chart. I'm going to use the bar chart. Let's come over here and get our data equals this label, which will be the data series label. And then I'm going to point to this and click and drag. Notice the data's right on top of each other. I did the same thing for here. Now we have our data set up that'll work nicely for two bars right next to each other. These labels up here will show up in our legend, which we can use as our chart title. Now, everything's set up. The only trick is we need a label here. And that chart, the bar chart, is going to assume that we want one label for these two data points. But we want two. So I'm going to build a formula here that'll create two labels, one on top of each other. I'm going to click there, use the ampersand shift 7, which means a join, and I'm going to use the character function. Hey, what's the character function? It returns an ASCII character if you put in a code. For example, 65 is the letter A, and 10 is hard return. So no way we can have a hard return built right into our formula. Finally, we ampersand shift 7 and get our other label. Control enter, and double click and send it down. Then I have to come over here and adjust that. Now we have our labels just as we want them, one on top of each other. Highlight this, go up to Insert. I'm going to go to Bar and select this one. Now let's look at these. Oh, lined up perfectly, but look, there's a problem. Mr. Excel has the little one and Excel is Fun has the big one. That is not right. So I'm going to go over here, click here and F2. This one needs to be A11, and this one needs to be 2. Control Enter. Now we have them right. The iTunes has the big bar. I'm going to double click and send that down, adjust all those labels. We'll do a few last quick things. Right click, Format Legend will show at the top. Maybe change the font size to 16. And I'm going to scoot this down a little bit. Zoop. And let's add some data labels. Right click, Add Data Labels. You could also click on the bar, go to Layout, Data Labels, and then Outside. Finally, we don't need these lines. And look at this. This is chart junk. If we have the numbers there, let's get rid of that right there. And so there we have it. There's a nice presentation for the differences between two sets of data. All right, I'm going to throw it back to Mr. Excel.
Hey, all right, Mike, that's great. When I look at this, I say, all right, well, the components are mildly interesting, but what's really important is the total number. So I want to have a chart that's going to allow us to compare the total number of Bill and Mike. And so, just like Mike, I had to rearrange the data. I kind of looked at this and said, okay, let's see what categories are similar. We have podcasts, mine on iTunes, Mike's on YouTube, and then DVD courses, that's the live lessons and total training, and then all of Mike's college videos, and then the new category. And I put this one separate because I'm trying to convince Mike that we should start doing more online videos for the Office Academy. And so it's going to be really small, not even show up in the chart, but basically I have this data set, and I'm going to go through and create a stacked column chart, stacked column. So insert, column, and I want to do the stacked column, not the 100% stacked. There's all kinds of problems with that, so we're going to do a stacked column. And initially, Excel gets the data wrong, so we want to switch that data. Much easier now in Excel 2007, we come here and switch row column, and we end up with two columns, a Bill column and a Mike column. Now, to put these a little bit closer to each other, I'm going to right-click Format Data Series, and then go to the gap and say that I want a very little gap. That's going to get us closer. Want to move the legend up to the top. That's back here on the layout tab. Legend, show legend at the top. Always want to show the legend either at the top or the left. Helps people who are reading the chart. And maybe we don't need to make everything quite as wide, so we'll make it a little bit more narrow. So that's how I would go about it. And, you know, as I look at this chart, I'm comfortable and I say, all right, I'm ahead of Mike. But I need to warn you here that in this case, this is, you know, this happens a lot with companies. They say, all right, well, we want to see how we're doing against the competition. So they dream up some measure, create a nice chart from that measure, and it gives everyone a warm, fuzzy feeling that things are going well. But as I started to think about this, I mean, Mike said to me that he saw my videos first, gave him an idea, and he started doing videos. And I think that's great that he's out there doing videos, but then I started to wonder about velocity and acceleration. So I took this data and I created it in a completely different format. I started to look at the number of videos that have been produced month by month and an accumulated number of videos. So I started back in October 2005. I was rolling along doing one a day every weekday, and you know, things were going along well. And then Mike really just started doing his videos in June of 2008. So he has been cranking to get that close. And so when we chart these two series, mine in blue and Mike in red, you see, yeah, I am ahead, but I need to worry if my competitive nature matters at all, because Mike clearly is on a very fast trend line to pass me. Now, a cool thing we can do here, you'll see that I added extra months beyond where I had data. That gives me stuff to the right of the chart. And I'm going to right-click both lines, right-click, and say add trend line, and we'll just let it be a linear trend line. Click close, and then I'll do the same thing for mine, add trend line, again a linear trend line, and we'll click close. And what we see here is that, sure enough, this is predicting somewhere around July 2009, Mike is going to surpass me. So while I should enjoy my lead right now, I know that clearly Mike is on a trend to completely beat me. There you go. All right. Well, hey, several different cool charting tricks. Hope you found this useful. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.